Hi students, welcome to the video lecture of module 5 topic additive manufacturing. Additive manufacturing refers to a process by which digital 3D design data is used to build up a component in layers by depositing material. Additive manufacturing is an appropriate name to describe the technologies that build 3D objects by adding layer upon layer of material, whether the material is plastic, metal, concrete, or one day human tissue. The term 3D printing is increasingly used as synonymy for AM, that is additive manufacturing is referred as 3D printing. However, later is more accurate in that it describes a professional production technique which clearly distinguished from conventional methods of material removal. So as the name itself indicates, additive manufacturing is a process of adding the materials layer by layer and allowing it to cure. Instead of milling a workpiece from a solid block, AM builds up component layer by layer using materials which are available in fine powder form. A range of different metals, plastics, and composite materials may be used. Common to AM technologies is the use of a computer, 3D modeling software, that is computer-aided design or CAD, machine equipment, and layering material. Once a CAD sketch is produced, the AM equipment, that is additive manufacturing equipment, reads in data from the CAD file and lays down or adds successive layers of liquid, powder, sheet material or other in a layer upon layer fashion to fabricate a 3D object. So now let us see what are the principles of additive manufacturing. AM technologies fabricate models by fusing, sintering or polymerization of material in predetermined layers with no needs of tools. Additive manufacturing makes possible the manufacture of complex geometries including internal part detail that are approximately not possible to manufacture using machining and molding processes because process does not require predetermined tool paths, draft angles and undercuts. As the product which is required is modeled in the software, dear friends, which has been given as the input to the machine. So based on the whatever the model we have created, we'll get the same replica in terms of the materials whatever we select. In additive manufacturing, the layers of a model are formed by slicing CAD data with professional software. All additive manufacturing systems work on the same principle. However, layer thickness depend upon parameters and machine being used, and thickness of layer range from 10 micrometer up to 200 micrometer. Layers are clearly visible to the part surface in additive manufacturing operation, which controls the quality of final product. The relation between thickness of layer and surface orientation is known as staircase effect. However, thinner the layer is the longer the processing time and higher the part resolution. So what they say, the layer thickness, if it is thin, it takes the processing longer and at the same time the quality of the product will be very good. Now let us see what is slicing CAD models for additive manufacturing. Process planning includes the steps for slicing the parts, triangulated surface, tool path generation for each layer and conversion of the tool path data to a suitable CNC data, that is G codes. The latter two steps are well established and are almost identical to CNC milling. Different part slicing algorithms for various additive manufacturing processes exist. Adaptive slicing is one of the approaches to resolve the inevitable staircase effect by using variable thickness. The advantages of additive manufacturing technologies are: complexity is free, that is, it actually costs less to print a complex part. Instead of a simple cube of the same size, the more complex or the less solid the object is, the faster and cheaper it can be made through additive manufacturing. Variety is free, that is, any variety of products can be manufactured using additive manufacturing. If a part needs to be changed, the change can be simply be made on the original CAD file and the new product can be printed right away. So as you know, people have worked on CAD software, it becomes very easy to modify the data. For example, if you want to increase the diameter, thickness, it becomes very easy. So you can go to the CAD file, you can make the modification, you can edit the original CAD file, what are the changes are required. Same thing can be inputted to the machine so that it gets incorporated. No assembly required. Yes, dear friends, no assembly is required. The old assembly can be manufactured here. Moving parts such as hinges and bicycle chains can be printed in metal directly into the product, which can significantly reduce the part numbers. A little lead time, that is, minimum lead time is required. Engineers can create a prototype with a 3D printer immediately after finishing the part's stereolithography, that is called as STL file, as soon as the part has printed. Engineers may then begin testing its property instead of waiting weeks or months for a prototype or part to come in. And very little skill of manufacturing is required for additive manufacturing. While complicated parts with specific parameters and high-tech applications are to be left to the professionals, even children in elementary school have created their own figures using 3D printing processes. That is the ease of producing the products using additive manufacturing process, dear friends. Few constraints, only few constraints will be there in additive manufacturing technologies. Anything you can dream up and design in the CAD software, you can create the additive manufacturing. The creativity, whatever you have in your mind, if you put it in the CAD model, the same will be printed and it will be in front of you and in a solid model. Less waste. Because of the material that is needed is used, there is very little, if any, material is wasted. As the material is added layer by layer, so here further finishing operation, we can't remove the machines, so it saves the material. Infinite shades of materials. Engineers can program parts to have specific colors in the CAD files, and printers can use materials of any color to print them. So you will have, if you see, it is mainly used in toys, dear friends. If you see toys of kids and all, you have variety of colors. If you want to change, same objects can be created in multiple colors depending on the material you use. So there are some limitations of additive manufacturing technologies. Let us see what are those. Slow build rates. Many printers lay down material at a speed of 1 to 5 cubic inches per hour depending on the part needed. Other manufacturing processes may be significantly faster. So this is one of the major limitations here. Higher production cost. Sometimes parts can be made faster using techniques other than additive manufacturing. So the extra time can lead to higher costs. Considerable effort in application design and setting process parameters. Extensive knowledge of material design and the additive manufacturing machine itself is required to make quality parts. So the operator need to have the knowledge of what material has to be selected for that particular product. Requires post-processing. Yeah, every manufacturing process requires post-processing. The surface finish and dimensional accuracy may be lower quality than other manufacturing methods. Discontinuous production process. Parts can only be printed one at a time, preventing economics of scale. So this continuous production process is not possible in additive manufacturing process. Limited component size or small build volume. So huge product cannot be manufactured in additive manufacturing process. In most cases, polymer products are about 1 cubic yard in size, while metal parts may only be 1 cubic foot. While larger machines are available, they will come at a cost. It will be more costlier. It won't be economic for company to buy. Poor mechanical properties. Layering and multiple interfaces can cause defects in the product. Thank you, dear friends. So